The people that made it happen were farmers from the neighborhood, like Leland Miller and Jamie Nags, the county agent. Luzern Moore and his brother were against it. Wilma Brenneiser and Mrs. Stout started it. The kids were the ones that really made it go. And I guess most of us live for our kids anyway.
People didn't seem to know their neighbors half as well as they used to. A lot of the time we'd just pass each other on the road, going 60 miles an hour. I didn't like that feeling. We had a new way of life, a lot different from the days of the old one-room schoolhouse. Maybe that's why we went back to it that morning. How much things had changed when I saw the school bus go by without stopping. It was on its way to the new Consolidated School, 12 miles down the road. Well, that's progress. But maybe we'd lost something, too. Leela Miller and Jamie Nags, our county agent, were going to meet me, but they hadn't gotten here yet. Stood there thinking, it's too bad our kids didn't know some of the things we used to take for granted when we went to school here. Things like working and playing together, living together, the way a community should. When Leland arrived, it was like old times. We had all gone to school together.
Remember that old tin cup they had chained to this pump, Wilma?
Yes, and a lot of other things are missing too since you and I went to school, Leland. And that's just what I want to talk to you about. Now you take our kids, for instance. They're growing up just like strangers. Why, we have nothing to teach them to work, or play together, or to even keep them here.
There's not much for our children to do around here.
Jamie says, why don't we start, or just try, reactivating that 4-H club we used to have around here.
You had a good one before the war, the one you folks belonged to. The war broke it up.
We talked about it for nearly an hour. And agreed that we might solve our problems through our children. We weren't sure how folks would feel about the idea. The only way to find out was to try it. But the best thing about it was that we were going to make the old schoolhouse our center again. And that's how it all started.
We went around telling people about 4-H. And how much it helped young folks in rural areas. But when we asked people to give us some of their time, we found out right then what had happened to our community.
You'd make a good leader in Derry. You know as much about that as anyone around here.
Not me. I haven't the time.
How much does it cost?
Nothing.
You say your boys are going to join?
Sure they are. I think we should all get behind this. It'll do us a lot of good in return.
Well, I think my boys can learn all they need to learn right on the farm.
I don't think there'll be any use in my joining 4-H because I'm going to leave here as soon as I'm 18.
Well, you are. Where are you going, Ann?
Oh, I don't know. St. Louis or Kansas City or someplace. There's nothing to do around here.
Well, we'll sure miss you, Ann. Sorry you can't be in 4-H. If you change your mind, be sure and let us know.
I will. Well, bye now.
Bye, Ann.
You know, Mrs. Brenizer, what you said about there being no community feeling around here really strikes pretty close home, I don't mind telling you. We came here 2 years ago to raise our kids away from town, but we're still like strangers here. Now, you take my daughter, Mary. She hasn't gotten to know any boys and girls her own age. She gets home from school and she just mopes around the house. Sometimes I wonder if we didn't make a mistake coming here. Now, this 4-H club, the way you tell about it, sounds like a good thing. I'm in favor of it. Sounds like just what this community needs.
I had my heart set on going to that first 4-H meeting, but right at the last minute, Effie decided to have her calf.
I told my family to go ahead and have fun. I'm stuck. Evie, I said, you sure picked your times all right. Now let's you and me get to work, and maybe I'll get to that meeting yet.
You know, it just occurred to me, what am I doing up here running this meeting? You've just elected yourself a new president. Come on up here, Richard Miller, and start working.
I'm out of the next mistake.
Don't worry about that, Richard. We all learn by doing.
Are there any further nominations?
I withdraw my nomination in favor of Pat Kirby.
Well, that just leaves Pat. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, Pat, I guess you're just stuck with it. I'm elected. I guess that just about winds the business meeting up.
I'm having you stay the 4-H club pledge now.
Okay. Jamie just made a good suggestion. Let's all stand and say the 4-H pledge like we have practiced it. Okay. Next thing on the agenda is the refreshments.
Come on, folks. The food's ready. Don't be bashful, children. Come on.
It's a surprise to you coming here. It's a real pleasure, Luzerne.
Don't blame me. I guess you'll have to blame these boys of mine for that. They've just been pestering me. I guess it's a party you're having here they want to be in.
We hope this is going to be more of a party for these boys.
Come on, folks, and get something to eat before it's all gone. Thanks, I don't believe I want anything. How about you, Lyle? Do you feel like eating?
I expect I'm too lazy to eat anything now.
How about the little girl? Honey, don't you want to come and play with the boys and girls? I wish you would, Mary.
Looks like we're going to get one tonight. then, when the roof started to leak, we decided to fix that old schoolhouse.
The club gave us something in common. It gave us a reason to work together. Started us doing things that we could look at after they were finished and say, we did that, all of us. People stopped being strangers and got acquainted all over again. The old schoolhouse was becoming more than a club. It was turning into a community center. We got our 4-H project started too. It was good to see our boys and girls getting together from all over the countryside. Carl Brenneiser had offered to lead the sheep project. The county home agent and I assisted in training the 4-H club leaders. The kids were awkward at first, but they loved it. They were getting to know each other by working together.
Mrs. Rhodes and Mrs. Price, our county home demonstration agent, organized a sewing project for some of the girls. The younger you start to learn, the better.
We raise a lot of beef in our community, and the beef project made the kids a lot more useful, taught them things their parents didn't have time to. The local tractor dealer sponsored the most popular project, tractor maintenance. So many farms today are mechanized. It means that most good farmers have to be good mechanics too.
The social side of 4-H is of great value too. In every community, there are the shy ones who want to be a part of the group, but don't seem to know how. We solve some of those problems too.
Something was going on, and the kids' enthusiasm was contagious.
A new interest in everything, even a walk on a hilltop with our kids, made us see things that we had never noticed before.
And the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches, and the lust of other things entering in. Choke the word.
Each year, churches all over the country observe National 4-H Sunday. It was the first time we had all gone to church in a group, and it seemed pretty special.
And bring forth fruit, some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100.
Our Heavenly Father, bless us in our fellowship as 4-H members and our families. Forgive us our sin and help us in following Thee that we may be faithful in serving our club, our community, and our country. Amen.
Thank you, Edwin. Thank you, Karen. We will worship God by singing hymn number 219, Faith of Our Fathers. Every September, the town has its annual corn and livestock show. For the first time in years, the local kids were playing the leading role. But the parents were even more excited than their kids. It seemed like the whole town was finally pulling together. We didn't win many prizes, but we sure had the time of our life.
Luzerne's barn. The fire department was out on another call, and when that happens in a town like ours, you're out of luck. been times in the past when Luzerne hadn't been too easy to get along with. But we forgot about that now. He'd gotten to be one of us, and he needed our help.
The spirit of a community is an elusive thing. It stays hidden until you need it most. Trouble like this brings it out.
Four days later, the whole town turned out at Luzerne's place for a real old-fashioned barn raising. Luzerne was sure surprised. The businessmen in town contributed money. The rest of us contributed the labor. It seemed like everybody wanted to chip in.
Up at the house, we were getting ready for big appetites.
By the time I got there, the kids had moved right in on their share of the job, and I thought, 4-H has really taught these kids something. Halfway up when we went to dinner.
Make us worthy of thy love. And we ask thee to bless the work of our hands and the people of this community who are gathered here as neighbors and friends in the spirit of helpfulness. Amen.
It was more than a meal. It was a social event. It's a fine thing to see a town come back to life again. Jamie Nags, Leland Miller, Wilma Brenneiser, and all the others had done quite a job. There was a new feeling in the air, and Luzerne felt it too. It was a good feeling. The feeling people get when they've lost something important and then find it again. It always takes people to make anything happen. These people brought a whole town back to life.
Working and playing together, living together, the way a community should. When Leland arrived, it was like old times. We had all gone to school together.
Remember that old tin cup they had chained to this pump, Wilma?
Yes, and a lot of other things are missing, too, since you and I went to school, Leland. And that's just what I wanted to talk to you about. Now, you take our kids, for instance. They're growing up just like strangers. Why, we have nothing to teach them to work or play together or to even keep them here.
There's not much for our children to do around here.
Jamie says, why don't we start, or just try, reactivating that 4-H club we used to have around here.
Something wrong with our town. People didn't seem to know their neighbors half as well as they used to. A lot of the time we'd just pass each other on the road, going 60 miles an hour. I didn't like that feeling. We had a
for you.
I stood there thinking, it's too bad our kids didn't know some of the things we used to take for granted.
The people that made it happen were farmers from the neighborhood, like Leland Miller and Jamie Nags, the county agent. Luzerne Moore and his brother were against it. Wilma Brenneiser and Mrs. Stout started it. The kids were the ones that really made it go. And I guess most of us live for our kids anyway.
Different from the days of the old one-room schoolhouse. Maybe that's why we went back to it that morning. I realized how much things had changed when I saw the school bus go by without stopping. It was on its way to the new Consolidated School, 12 miles down the road. Well, that's progress. But maybe we'd lost something, too. Leland Miller and Jamie Nags, our county agent, were going to meet me, but they hadn't gotten here yet.